Welcome to the panel, Goomba Head.
What's good?
Thank you. Is that your Cash App? You welcome to share it.
Yep.
What's up, Goomba?
Do you mind coming on camera with me?
Right now?
Don't be.
Yeah, just for a second, so people can verify that it's you. That's all.
Oh yeah, I can verify. No problem.
Okay. It's me. All right. Welcome to the live. I hope you don't mind, because we're not gonna baby you in here, honey.
Today, I'm not looking to be baby.
Okay, because we feel like you're just as much a part of this as anybody.
Of course.
Yeah, you have a lot of responsibility in what's happening with your wife right now.
Of course.
Yeah. So anyway, go ahead, y'all. Was there something you wanted to say? Should I give you the room for a moment?
No, no, go ahead. I mean, I see everybody got questions and stuff. You know, everybody want to ask.
Who's got a question?
I just got a question. What's tea? I mean, Goomba, like, with her calling Arizona on you and all that, like,
what happened with this fire? That's what we want to know. What's the real story with the fire?
Carrie did it.
I don't know.
No, you know, you're not gonna do that with us. You're not gonna come up here and lie. We're not gonna do that. We're not gonna do that.
Carrie.
We're not gonna have you come up here like, cause you sat in that hot tub and both of y'all sat there needing bras and both of y'all sat there and said P. Diddy did.
Hey, needing bras. Right.
So you're not gonna sit here and tell us you don't know, cause you said you called the Uber and went back to the hotel.
Because
you're saying you don't know. So are you gonna lie? You gonna tell the truth? Are you gonna lie? You gonna tell the truth?
Everybody know, right? So what I say?
Marquise, you got anything?
So when you push, so when you blew the car up and you pushed down the side of the road,
how many crackheads did you pay to help you?
How many crackheads did it take to turn the light bulb?
I mean, you know.
You can see it.
How many crackheads does it?
It looks like your eyebrows had got a little burnt off. I had to.
Y'all funny.
I mean, because it obviously there was an impact to that Kia. Prior to the fire.
That's why y'all was in that pool. You was burnt.
Miss T said his eyebrows were singed.
Right. They were gone. Lord Jesus. Y'all crazy.
Well, I'll tell you what, I am happy that you finally saw that it was time for you to exit, although you should have bended that.
That's so true. I could have.
Back over the time, right. But better late than never, because what she's, you know, doing is out of control. And
right.
Somebody's gonna get hurt. Seriously, the way she's.
Yeah, that is true.
She's
right.
Gonna, you know, she make one false move, and one of them officers is gonna, you know, react. And
that's one of the main reasons why I put the white one on her, because I didn't want that shit to happen to her when I cared. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it looked like she's not, it doesn't matter. She don't care.
Oh, so she's now you admit you did it.
No, I've been unadmitted I did it.
You was deflecting.
I did it first.
You
then
initiated
I was like,
it last time I checked.
Well, that's the last time you checked. You might want to check again.
Well,
I said I did it.
Ain't that important to me, friend.
I remember he had
up in that motherfucker.
It.
I was clapping and breakdancing, moonwalking. Pulled out my silver glove.
No, you didn't.
But
she was more like a Billy. Why you got her on Billie Jean?
Jesus, man.
I know
Goomba said he ain't the one, y'all.
The consensus also is that a lot of people could have called on her though, because she recorded all those calls and played them on live.
And it's a fact that other folks did put in reports on her, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't my family, I'll tell you that right now. The show wasn't my family.
How long has she known Legina?
12 years.
Nigga, please. Not that I fucking know. If it was 12 years, I wouldn't know nothing about that.
I'm just
playing. As long
how long
as
has she
known
Legina? How long
as long
did,
as
how
I
long?
Know
so how long was that? I mean, you here, you might as well tell the truth. Are you just here for attention?
Are you listening? Are you listening? God damn it!
Don't walk around in circles with us, okay?
Ain't nobody walking in circles.
I'm not your baby. First of all, you can never get a woman like me. Let's be clear. Okay. Second of all, if you're gonna come on here, you're gonna give us straight answers. We're not gonna walk around in circles and do all that bullshit, or I'll remove you. Okay, you're not gonna waste my audience's time. I'm not here for that.
You can remove me anyways. You've been on there 2 hours, and it don't really matter.
Don't be.
There you go, y'all. I'm not gonna have this man up here walking around talking. I don't need the views like that. Okay?
Why he acting like that?
See, that's what I'm not gonna do. I'm not gonna have this man come before y'all doing all that circle talking. You either gonna answer the question straight or you gonna get the fuck out the house.
That nigga's a liar.
I would not have any of you in here doing that.
No.
Okay?
I already know.
And I already said I'm not gonna baby him. I'm not desperate for views. I didn't invite him here. I've never shared my link with him. I've never commented on anything he's done. So he found his way over here to our house. So he's got to abide by the house rules. And the house rules are, this is not a no judgment zone, nigga.
No.
You're not about to sit here and dance around questions. Okay, y'all got questions. He said that. We didn't say it. So now we ask it 3 questions. See, he can't answer none of them straight. Go back to that other bitch with them twins and go figure out what to do with that mediocre pussy. Because you're not going to come over here to top shelf pussy and women that are intelligent and hone our crafts and talk that bullshit. Talking in circles like Jag did you for 4 years and 21 days.
Ooh, yeah.
So you can get the fuck off my platform with that bullshit. We're not doing that. Go somewhere where somebody needs the views. I don't get paid to do this. I have a career.
Okay.
This is my hobby. And I don't keep friends in my life who are like that. Miss Nader's will tell you, we've been friends for years. I don't keep people in my life who talk in circles
and
like
he's playing too much.
How long did she know her? Long as I've known her by, nigga. Please. And that's why your dick itches. That's why you sit here with an itchy dick now. Bleeding out your ass for 3 weeks. Now, when you go get an STD test, I bet you want a straight answer, ho. Don't come in my fucking house with that bullshit. You better ask about me. I don't put up with that bullshit. I wasn't raised like that. Shit. I hope y'all enjoyed that moment with Goomba.
I enjoyed it very well. You queen. Yeah.
What we're not going to do is come up in here. This is the breakdown crew. We come here to do business. If you come up on this platform, you come here to do business. We're going to kiki and we're going to laugh, but we're going to tell the fucking truth.
Yeah, I thought we was going to get some answers for real.
Yeah, I did, so.
Y'all know we weren't going to get no answers. I kept my finger on that button. I knew that was coming.
Because he came up.
But hear her. If he gave answers, I would have never had to ask those questions.
That's true.
No, I'm saying if he gave straight, he hit the link. I assumed that he was gonna.
It's Friday night. He needs something to do. Cause old girl is with her other baby daddy. He needs something to do. Jaguar just started fucking a trucker. He needs something to do. Ain't nobody answering his phone calls. He can't be seen. We'll cover that tomorrow night. I can't tell too much.
Girl.
You know I don't come with shit without evidence. Because that's what we do here.
Yeah.
He at home trying to figure out something to do. His homeboys don't fuck with him. The dudes at the barbershop don't fuck with him. He probably withdrawing. Coming here with that bullshit. I told you we're not going to baby you just because you look like a grown-ass kid. I'm 42 years old and I'm credentialed. I work every single day. Get up at 4 o'clock every single fucking morning. I'm not about to sit here and use my internet to babysit you so you can have some attention. I done had conversations with niggas like that. They'll talk you in circles for hours for attention. Just to have attention.
Yeah, that's true.
The fact that he didn't even come up here on screen let me know he didn't take it seriously. I had to make the nigga get on camera. Just to show it was him. That's the only thing I wanted to do. I don't never want nobody to be able to say, oh, that wasn't me.
Right.
I didn't invite that nigga into this facility. He came here on his own and he didn't come here to tell the truth. He's not going to tell you what really happened with the car because he's in on it. He's not going to tell you what really happened with Angela because he's in on it.
Yeah.
Don't play them kind of games with me. We live by integrity over here. Shit, I got a $135 registration bill to ADOT, and you around here blowing up cars in my city, and I gotta pay taxes for that shit. What? Fucking bitch ass nigga. You better be glad you. Oh, I cut to you. Ooh, Jesus. I can't stand that. That's disrespectful to y'all for this man to come up here and talk about y'all got questions and then talk you in circles. We are an intellectual crew. We are an, see, he ain't watched us enough to know we break down shit over here. We kiki, we laugh, we smoke our weed, but we are an intellectual crew. Right. That's what we are. We are big nerds. We all got jobs we've worked hard to have and keep. We got requirements and training. We read.
That's true.
You're not gonna come over here. See, that's the thing. Black people, we allow people to play with us like that because everybody thinks we're the class clowns. No. We are not the class clowns. We run shit. Don't let that bitch ass nigga come in here with his overgrown beard. Go to the barbershop with that dumb shit. When he start talking in circles, it's time to go. Well, you can remove me now. Bye, bitch. Don't nobody need your views. Ain't nobody checking for you. I had to find you. You ain't on my recommendations. Shit, you've been exploiting your wife for years and that shit backfired on you. Now you bleeding out your ass.
Yeah, it did backfire like a mother.
Because he thought he was going to be Mr. Jaguar, right? But she ain't even Mrs. Don't nobody know her for shit. He was going to ride her coattails. He's talking about something. You know, I wanted. Oh, God, we're going to watch that interview tomorrow. I'm talking about some shit I ain't even presented to y'all yet. Talking about you wanted to be in the background. Because you are unambitious. You are unstudied. You have no work ethic. Shit. Ran straight to another woman. You didn't go build on your own. You left this woman and went and slept on another woman's couch. You ain't got nowhere to go. Nothing to do without her. You didn't leave her and then go get an apartment downtown like my niggas would have done.
Facts.
You didn't leave her and then go stay at your other condo where you was fucking bitches anyway. Not even a hotel room. You wouldn't stay with a woman and her kids. You staying in some children's house. You eating they snacks and drinking all they Capri Suns. Nigga, you a guest in some children's house. Nigga, you taking a bath in the same bath as some children.
Why did he get off my nerves with the facial expressions?
Don't come in here with that bullshit. I'm a grown-ass woman. I don't collect weak men. Sorry,
no,
Riley.
He's very weak, and you ask very direct questions. He want to deflect, because he's used to deflecting. And he ain't used to a strong black woman that's sane, because, you know, Jag is strong, but she ain't sane. And you came with a director, he was giving you playing with you like a kid. And you were
not going to do it. Mm-mm. I can't sit before my investors and give them fucked up answers.
Preach.
When my boss reaches out to me and says, hey, I checked out this, what happened? I can't be like, well, you know, long as you did it, I did it. No, we got to have a real business conversation. If something was presented to me the other day that I knew was a lie, and I had two bosses in the room, was like, tell me the fucking truth. What's tea? And they said, well, you know, okay. And I said, okay, it won't leave the room, but you got to be honest with me. I'm not about to sit here and play games with that nigga because he needs some attention tonight because he's sitting up in army clothes and he needs to feel itself important. Watching tank videos. Bitch ass nigga.
Not sitting in army clothes watching tank videos. Oh my
God. Come on, that was his house. No, that wasn't your house. That was your house and Jaguar's mama's house. You might have been fucking her mama.
Oh, I'm gonna try and come back. My uncle's calling me. I'm gonna try and come back.
What's up? Is he fine? I'm just playing.
You stupid. All right, bye.
Bye, girl. You can have him here, her. Wait, I just went off on that nigga. I might need to stay away for a minute. Shoot, men don't like when women talk to them like this, but this is what you need, sir.
He's probably turned.
There's not a woman I roll with that would be with Goomba. Yeah. Not a nigga, woman I roll with. He let day and night call him Goomba. Don't you realize they were shading you, bitch ass? You let them niggas give you and you too stupid to trademark it because I wrote it down today. play with me. You won't be able to sell a t-shirt without coming through me. But you ain't got the ambition to do it anyway, so I ain't even got to worry about that. I'd be wasting my $800. You ain't even done that much research on your own name to find out how much it would cost to trademark it. I did, stupid. I'm about to own you and your fucking lame-ass, dirty diaper-ass wife. Shit. He ain't even mad she called the police on him.
Yeah.
He ain't even mad.
I wouldn't have been in that chat modding and saying nothing. It would have been just no contact, straight up. When I couldn't believe it when I heard that video recording.
And he doing a press junket. He done come on here for free. And my numbers didn't change the 3 moments he was in here. Because what you're supposed to do when you come on my platform, I have it designed for you to bring your audience with you. Nobody came with Goomba. I lost nothing when I removed him. Absolutely nothing. Nobody in the ethos was like, don't do that. Not one person in the chat. You could go back. Nobody in the chat was like, why'd you do that? We handle business. I'm not gonna let that bitch come up here and want to debate with me about my religion when that's not what we're talking about. I'm not gonna let Goomba come here before you guys and run you through circles. What I'm gonna do, sit back and let him do that to y'all? After I challenge you every single week and sometimes twice a week to train your brain and not be afraid to think and criticize and be critical about every fucking thing that comes across your screen, why would I let him sit here and play games with 4 people and I just sit back and kiki over because he brought, you know, because people enjoy. Fuck that shit. That's like me flirting with a bagger at Walmart. Yeah, they don't even have them.
That's not happening.
That's like me letting a nigga walk. You understand what I'm saying? Like, why am I going to give that nigga the time of day and he's not even here to be real? He's not going to give us, because the questions I asked are the questions I have. I could care less what made him fall in love with that hoe ass bitch. That's between him and his mama. Okay? I could care less if she's pregnant. That's between them and the state. The only thing that matters to me is what happened with that car and how long has your wife, who you've now proven is legally your wife, you went to the work to prove that, nigga.
But this is the thing. I was saying I could understand him not responding to the car thing if he had a part in it, right?
But don't come up here to
ask him about LaGina, and the second you give an answer for that, I was like, yeah.
Did he answer the question? He answered the question. He answered it like, Marquise Wiley, you've been a man for how many years?
Yes, 32 years.
Did he answer the questions?
He did not. He deflected.
He answered them the way a lying ass nigga answers those questions. Yeah. Because my ex-husband taught me. He said, if a man repeats your question, he waiting. He trying to figure out how to tell you a lie. If a woman repeats your question, she truly didn't understand it. But if a man repeats your question, he's most likely thinking up a lie. How long she known LaGina?
Exactly.
What happened to the car? Nigga, you been here long enough to know what we talking about.
Right, you heard what I said.
What did you think of? Because I thought about all the questions I could ask, but this is not a tabloid show. We call the police. So I need those who are watching to know what happened to the car. And how long your wife has really known LaGina. Because we suspect it's been at least 3 months. How long you think his wife known that lady? You think his wife just met LaGina 3 weeks ago? Not after listening to him?
Mm-mm, absolutely not.
Because I had an idea that Sean Davey Way wasn't married. Something in my mind was like, that nigga ain't married. Somebody did the research. Somebody did the research. Because all you need is a LexisNexis account. Little LexisNexis to find out what's on your credit report, honey.
I think they scared us. Yeah. I think they scared us.